हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द ब्लड ग्रुप. वी हैव डिस्कस द फोर ब्लड ग्रुप्स, दैट इज ब्लड ग्रुप ए बी एंड ओ. ओके, दिस वाज़ द फोर डिफरेंट ब्लड ग्रुप वी हैव डिस्कस. इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द मेन पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर, दैट इज द प्रॉपर हार्ट. ओके, दैट इज द ब्लड सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. In this part, it is very important from the board point of view, because a diagram based questions and objective based of questions are asked from this part. So you have to be very precise with this part. Okay, you have to watch this video carefully, because many of the questions, as I already mentioned, will be asked from this part. So what is exactly the blood circulatory system is comprises of? So see, the name itself suggests that is a blood. So definitely there would be blood. To carry that blood, there would be a blood vessel. Suppose this is a blood, okay? So this blood is not going to flow openly. It has to flow under someone. So it has to flow under this vessel. So this is the blood vessels. Now, see, blood and blood vessels are going to do their job, that is of the transportation, okay? Blood vessels, you can assume this as the road. Okay, it is a road, and blood you can assume it as a good. The good has been transported through the road, but there would be a person, okay, who is going to transport up this good. So that person I am going to consider it is a heart. So you can understand in a more simple and easier way, there is a person who wants to transport some goods or parcel some good. So definitely through the medium of a road he is going to transport that part. So you can assume like that. A person is going to transfer the goods, and that goods will be transported through the medium of road. Okay? See. So first, so I'm going to make you show the location, okay, of the heart. See, we can see out here. There is a heart. Okay? And there are some blue, red color veins, arteries that is arising inside the body. Okay, there are millions and billions in numbers, the capillaries also. Okay, now this blood vessels comprise of three parts, that is arteries, veins and capillaries, means the road part. Okay, you can assume like that. Now this is the heart. If you look at the heart, so we always keep on telling the heart is on the left side. Okay, left side of our body. But it is not so. It is not exactly on the left side of your body. Where it is, where your heart is located, it is located is right in the center between the two lungs and above the diaphragm. What is a diaphragm? Suppose okay, this is a lung and this is the diaphragm. Okay, this is the diaphragm. So the heart is in the center between the two lungs. This is the lung part here. Here. It is located somewhere here. And above the diaphragm means this is the diaphragm, no? So it is somewhere located like this. So this is very important to understand about this part. Now this is the exact human heart looks like. Okay, in many of a time you have seen this, the heart looks like this. Okay, in your young ages, if you were told to draw the diagram of heart, so you draw like this. Okay, but exactly it's not so, it looks like this. So you have to be more precise with the diagram part as well. In exams, only the labeling part will be coming from the heart. Okay, you don't have to draw any heart diagram also. So there are different type of structures we can see out here. Okay, different type of the structures. Okay, inside the heart, what different structures are present. But as of now, right now, I'm not going to discuss about the different structures. Right now, I'm just going to discuss about the heart. So there is, see, I just wanted to notice one thing to you. दिस इज़ द वॉल ऑफ द हार्ट, मीन्स द आउटर पार्ट, एंड दिस इज़ द इनर स्ट्रक्चर. इफ़ यू लुक दिस लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ योर हार्ट एंड द वॉल, देर इज़ अ टू मच ऑफ गैप. बट द सेम स्ट्रक्चर इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी ऑन द राइट साइड एंड द वॉल ऑफ द राइट साइड, देर इज़ अ लेस अमाउंट ऑफ अ गैप. Why there is a left amount of a gap between this right side and the wall, and why there is a too much of gap on the left side and the left part of your heart? The reason is very simple. See, the wall of the left side and the inner structure of the heart has a too much of gap, because if you can see the color, it is reddish. What does red exactly indicate?
Red indicates the oxygenated blood. Okay, so that is why this is red in color. Oxygenated means the red in color. See, as we know that part, the heart has to throb fast, okay, and it has to pump the blood to each and every part of the body. As it has to pump the blood to each and every part of the body, it has to do the thing with the force. So when the heart forces, okay, so it supplies the blood to the each and every part of the body.
If you look at this diagram here it is the heart, exactly between the center, between the two lungs. The most of the part of the body is on the lower side than the heart. See this part. This part is highly
on the lower side. Okay? Lower side than the heart.
And if you keep your hands straight like this, so you would easily notice this part. कि दी हैंड पार्ट्स, दी हैंड पार्ट हियर एंड द फेस पार्ट इज़ अबाउ दी
हार्ट.
सो सी व्हाट हैपेंस,
मोस्ट ऑफ द ब्लड इट हैज़ टू ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी. तो लोअर पार्ट इट बिकम्स वेरी इजी ड्यू टू द ग्रेविटी. ओके, तो इट बिकम्स वेरी इजी. बट द सेम ब्लड व्हेन इट हैज़ टू ट्रांसपोर्टेड to the upper part of the body, I mean to say towards the hands, okay, and towards the face part where brain is located, and brain used most of the oxygen because it keeps on running 24/7. So where the most part is going to get occupied, it also has to transport towards the opposite direction of the gravity. Opposite means what? On the above side of the gravity. So that is why it has to exert a lot of force. So that is why there is a
So as we can see out here, there is too much of gap here. Too much of gap. There is too much of gap between this wall.
Okay? As it has to pump the blood at a very fast and with a very force.
Now this was
about the why
this is narrower. Okay? Why this was narrower.
Now I'm going to continue with the heart part only.
See, a human heart is a size of the fist. When you close up your fist, so it resembles up your heart only. Okay,
and this heart is protected. See, the heart is directly not exposed to the lungs. Okay, it has been covered by a membranous covering. Okay, on the front side, suppose this is a heart. Okay,
so I'm just going to help you. Okay, this is the covering, assume like this, which is present in front. This covering, this membranous covering, protects the heart, and this covering is called the pericardium. Why it is known as the pericardium? See, the word peri means the upper part, and the cardium means the cardiac, means your heart system only. Pericardium.
Now this pericardium contains up the lubricating fluid that is called as the pericardial fluid. What is the function of this pericardial fluid? It helps to reduce the friction between the heartbeat and protect it from the mechanical injury. Suppose if a person, okay, gets struck on the left side of the heart, so its heart does not get affected. Why? Because it has the covering which helps to prevent it from the injuries. Okay, and it also helps in the friction as well. Okay, it also helps in reducing the friction so
this part and this part does not get collapse. And if this part gets collapsed, so what is going to happen? Your heart will not function perfectly, and due to this, a person can die.
Now, see, as we said, we have spoke about the heart part. Now it's time for the blood vessels to come in. See, blood is very easy. We have discussed the blood in the detail part only. Now there are the different types of the blood vessels. Okay, different types of the blood vessels. What are the blood vessels? I said road. Okay, so there are two types of a blood vessels. One which enters into the heart, and one which leaves the heart. So this, see. The blood vessels which enters the heart are of two types, that is the anterior and posterior. What does anterior and posterior mean? See, anterior means the front side and posterior means the back side. The anterior vena cava also has one name, and that is very, very, very important name. That is called the superior vena cava. Right now I am just going to use the shortcut SVC, where S means superior. Superior means at the top. Okay, and posterior vena cava, which also has one name, that is IVC. What is IVC? Inferior vena cava. What is the meaning of the superior and what is the meaning of the inferior? Just keep on hold. I will explain you each and every part. These are the names. First, collect these names in your mind. Then we are going to start with the proceedings. Anterior means superior vena cava. Posterior means the inferior vena cava, and these two blood vessels are entering the heart. Okay, now these are entering, so someone has to leave them. So who is that someone? There are two, that is the pulmonary artery and the aorta. So in and all there are four of this. They are the anterior part, posterior part, 1, 2, 3, 4, but this above to one enters. Now, as I said, anterior has one name, that is called the superior vena cava, and this posterior has one name, that is called inferior vena cava. So basically, suppose I am drawing a heart. Okay, I already said heart doesn't look like this. Suppose this is a heart. So heart has been bifurcated into two parts, which has divided into two parts, and this part is called septum. Okay, just remember this name. This is a septum which divides the heart into two parts, that is the right hand side and the left hand side. Now according to you this is left hand side, okay, and according to you this is a right hand side, but it is not so. This is the left side of your heart and this is your right side of your heart. If you are going to see the heart in your way, so you will come to know, if suppose you are standing in the front direction, so you will assume that this is the left side and this is the right side. Okay, as you are seeing on the opposite side, so that is why you always keep on telling ki this is the left and this is the right. But as I already mentioned, this is not so. You have to be very perfect with this part. This is your left side of your heart and this is your right. You have to assume the heart in your way. Okay, so what is this anterior vena cava? See, the word I said anterior means the above, means the superior only. So there is an, see, superior, this is SVC, superior vena cava. See, in the above part also, in before that also I spoke to you about this part, that heart has to pump the blood on the lower side of the body and on the above side of the body. When the blood, okay, which is deoxygenated, This right side carries deoxygenated blood. So as it carries up the, this right side carries up the deoxygenated blood, it is always bluish in color. Okay, exactly it's not bluish in color, but for some diagrammatical explanation it is bluish in color. This right side carry deoxygenated blood. Which blood? Deoxygenated, which is been symbolized by a color blue. This is the superior vena cava. See, whenever your blood, suppose whenever your blood get deoxygenated, so what happens to that blood? From the above side, like from the brain, from the hands, it enters into the heart through this pipe. This pipe means this vessel is called as the superior vena cava. Okay, same the thing. See, whenever you run, so you with the help of the legs you run. Okay, whenever you eat up the food, with the help of the stomach you get digested up your food. So this is the lower half. Okay, the part which is below the heart. This is called IVC. What do you mean by IVC? Inferior vena cava. So what is the function of the superior? To bring the blood from the above side, from the part which is above the heart, to the right hand side. And inferior vena cava means what? To bring the blood from the lower region of the body, that is abdomen, means your stomach related intestine, and your leg region. Okay, and the right side always carries up the deoxygenated blood. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the leaving of the heart. So leaving of the heart means what? See, leaving of the heart means the pulmonary artery and the aorta. Where is pulmonary heart, pulmonary artery located? Here. Okay, and this pulmonary artery, okay, this pulmonary artery is arise from the right ventricle. From right ventricle means from the this part. Okay, and it is started from there. As this is a 2D diagram, if you look the heart in a 3D way now, so you will come to know that this right ventricle is connected with this pulmonary artery. What is the function of this pulmonary artery? To carry the deoxygenated blood for getting oxygenated. Okay, and from where it is going to get oxygenated? From the lungs. What is the function of this aorta? Where is aorta located? Here. Okay, here. Aorta. What is the function of this aorta? The function of this aorta is to transport blood to each and every part of the body. Okay, so aorta is very special because as it is not entering toward the heart, in fact it is working in a reverse fashion. It is supplying the blood to each and every part of the body. Okay, the blood are going to get moved out here. Okay, this was the aorta, and here it was the pulmonary artery. So both of them are leaving the heart. Okay, we can assume like this. Now there are some, see, now a question arises. Does the blood which is present inside the heart is pumped throughout the body? All the blood is pumped throughout the body? The answer is no. Not all the blood is transported to each and every part of the body. Some of the part of the blood is kept by the heart also. Suppose this. Suppose this is a heart. So as I said, it is going to pump the blood to each and every part of the body, but it is not going to completely lose its blood. Part of the blood it is going to keep for itself also. So they are known as the coronary artery. See, as we have studied about the entering and the leaving, now the coronary artery we are going to study. Why we are studying this coronary artery part? Because coronary artery is the arteries coronary artery. What is the function of this coronary artery? To transport oxygenated blood to the walls of the heart. So this coronary artery, as we know, the heart is a very muscular organ. So suppose there are many vessels which are present inside the heart. So this is the coronary artery, and the function of this is to supply the blood to the walls of the heart, so the function of the heart perform perfectly and the function of the heart does not get disturbed. If suppose any of the blockage, suppose there is, as I said, there are many of the coronary arteries which are present inside. Suppose this is an artery, okay? If suppose there is a blockage, this part is blocked, suppose. Okay? Suppose I am zooming this part. And suppose this part is got blocked. Okay? This coronary artery got blocked. So what is going to happen? If suppose there is a blockage in the coronary artery, it can lead to the death of the person. A person can die. Okay? And this condition in which the coronary arteries get blocked up is called as the myocardial infarction. Myocardial infarction. This is a biological word, but if I'm going to use an easy word for this myocardial infarction, so it means heart attack. So heart attack, its biological word is myocardial infarction, where it means that the coronary artery, there is a blockage in the coronary arteries, and due to which the blood is not going to be transported. Now, some of the time it happens that there is a chest pain, but the people often get confused. Okay, they think this is a heart attack only. It is not so. The chest pain, its biological word is called angina pectoris. Angina pectoris. It is a popular biological word which is known as the chest pain. When does the chest pain? When there is an insufficient supply of blood to the heart muscles. Okay, so there is no blockage, but there is not sufficient amount of a supply. Okay, the supply is very deficient. So due to this, the chest gets pain. Now we are going to discuss about the valves part. Valve regulate the flow of blood in the single direction. Now this valve is very important. Why this valve is very important? See. Why this valve is very important? Because as we have a house, okay, and every house is guarded by a door. And what is the function of this door? For the entry and the exit. Entry or exit. This is the function of a door. So same like that, we call this valve as door. Okay, and the function of this door is to regulate the blood flow. Okay, it helps the blood to get allowed or exit. So basically there are four types of valve: right atrioventricular, left atrioventricular, pulmonary semilunar valve and aortic semilunar valve. And where they are present exactly? See, I'm going to draw a heart structure. In that heart structure, you will be easily noticing each and everything. First, this is a heart. Okay, the heart has been divided by a septum, okay, into two parts. That is, this is the left and this is the right. The right side of the heart is deoxygenated, whereas the left side of the heart is oxygenated. Okay, so basically this would be red in color according to if you see in the test book, and the right side will be blue in color. Now see, I have divided the heart into two parts, that is the right hand side and the left hand side. Now heart have four chambers. See here, you can see out here, this is the upper side of the heart. This is the upper side of the heart, which is known as the atrium. Okay, so I'm going to call this as right atrium RA, and this is the left side, left atrium. Okay, this is the two part, and the lower part is called ventricle. Lower part means which? Here. This is the lower part. Again, it has been divided into two parts. This is the RV and this is LV. What does RV means? Right ventricle. What does LV means? Left ventricles. Okay. Now, where are these valves located? The valves, see this part here, see this part here, where it is present, one of the valve is present between the right atrium and right ventricle here. Okay, like this, here in between this. So this is called as the right atrioventricular. Okay, now there is something called left atrioventricular. Where is left atrioventricular? If you are going to see here, so this is the left side. So this is called the left atrioventricular. The atrium ventricular means what? In between the atrium and ventricular. Okay, so we have studied about this part. Now we are going to discuss where this pulmonary semilunar valve is present. This pulmonary semilunar valve is located at the opening of the right ventricle. Where? Here. Okay. And here there is a pulmonary artery, as I said. So this pulmonary ventricle leads to pulmonary artery. Okay, and this pulmonary artery, between this there is a valve here. Okay, pulmonary semilunar valve. So that is why it is called the pulmonary, because it is located in the pulmonary side. Okay, and now the aortic, see the name itself suggests where it is present, in the aortic region. And where is the aorta? Here. So here somewhere. So this were the different types of the valve we have discussed. Now each and every valves we are going to discuss them. See how the blood transportation has been done inside the heart. So first, what we are going to do, we are going to assume and look at the heart diagram first. This is the heart diagram. So we can see each and every part. Okay, see, we can see the superior vena cava. Okay, we can see the inferior vena cava. This is the inferior and this is the superior. ओके. तो ब्लड एज आई सेड द राइट साइड विल बी ऑलवेज ब्लू इन कलर, वी कैन सी द कलर एज वेल, एंड द लेफ्ट साइड इज ऑलवेज रेड इन कलर. तो वॉट डज ब्लू मीन्स? डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड. सो whenever we do any of the activity like running, jogging, any of the thing like eating of the food or something like that, the deoxygenated blood comes into the right atrium here, right atrium, okay. And how it comes into the right atrium? With the help of SVC, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. We can see these arrows also, okay. Both of this are entering inside the heart, the right atrium. Now when the blood is on the right hand side, so there is a valve, this is known as the tricuspid valve, okay. And where is this tricuspid valve presented? Between the left atrium here and right ventricle. Now one would be thinking, sir, you said it was atrioventricular valve, that is on the right side, right atrioventricular valve. This right atrioventricular valve is also called as the tricuspid valve. Why this is called as the tricuspid valve? Because word tri means three and cups means it is the shape of a cup, like this, they are three in numbers, so that is why it is called as the tricuspid valve. When this tricuspid valves open, okay, so how does it get open? There is the flap which held in the position. So this tricuspid is held with some of the tissue, okay, sorry, some of the muscles, that is called as the chordia tendinae, okay, chordia tendinae, which is muscular in nature. And whenever this right side, okay, right atriums get full, so this gets open and the blood enters into the right ventricle then, okay. Now we are on the right hand side, right ventricle. Now what is the function of the right ventricle? Since it is deoxygenated, so what the heart does, it sends the blood to the pulmonary artery. We can see this direction, you can follow up this direction. So there is one valve, okay, we can see out here, this is called as the pulmonary semilunar valve, okay, where it is present at the opening of the right ventricle. Where the right ventricle is opening, it is present into the pulmonary artery, the opening of the right ventricle into the pulmonary artery. What is the function of this? Okay, now what is the function of this pulmonary semilunar valve? See, pulmonary, your word means lungs, the word pulmonary means lungs, okay, pulmonary means lungs. And why does semilunar? Because see, lunar means the full moon day, so semilunar means the half, it resembles the shape of a moon, so that is why they have given the name as pulmonary semilunar valve, okay. Now the blood is going to go into this part, we can see this direction, we can follow up this direction, okay. Now where this pulmonary artery is going to lead? This pulmonary artery is going to lead to the lungs. Why it is going to lead to the lungs? Because as I said, the word pulmonary means lungs. So from the lungs, the carbon dioxide blood, I mean to say the deoxygenated blood get transported out of the body, and they only carry the oxygenated blood, okay, they only carry the oxygenated blood from there. From the lungs, once the blood get the oxygen, so it enters into the heart, it enters into the heart with the pulmonary vein, okay, pulmonary vein, we can see the arrow. When the oxygenated blood from the lungs toward the heart enters into the body, it enters into the right ventricle, and there is a, we can see out here, there is a structure which is present between the left atrium and left ventricle, which is called the mitral valve. This mitral valve is also called as the bicuspid valve. Okay, this mitral valve is also called as the bicuspid. Why bicuspid? Because again this is a cup shape, but the number is reduced to 2. So this mitral valve is also called as the bicuspid valve or left atrioventricular valve. So now this bicuspid valve get open and the blood enters into the left ventricle. Now once the blood enters into the left ventricle, as I already said, okay, there is a too much of distance between this part. Okay, so as I said, okay, there is a too much of distance, so it has to pump the blood to the all part of the body. So this left ventricular eventually gets into the aorta. Okay, and this is the valve. Okay, this is the valve, and this is called the aortic semilunar valve. Why aortic? Because it is present in the aorta region. Okay, and semilunar means the half, and from the aorta it get transported to each and every part of the body. And what is the main function of this valve? The main function of this valve is to prevent the backflow of the blood, because the blood has to flow in a unidirectional. What do you mean by unidirectional? Means in a single direction only. It does not have to flow in the bidirectional, okay, or any other direction. It has to flow in a single direction, that is the unidirectional. So that is why these valves are there. So these valves are nothing but the protective cover, okay, which helps to prevent the backflow of the blood. If suppose once the blood enters into the right atrium, it comes into the left ventricle, so again from the left ventricle it is not going to go into this direction. Okay, understand like this. Suppose I am in the right atrium, and this is the right ventricle. When the blood from the right atrium, it passes into the right ventricle. Okay, so there is a valve, as I said. So I am drawing a line out here to make you understand. So from this right ventricle, the blood is not going to enter again into the right atrium. Once it reaches into the right ventricle, it has to get transported through this pulmonary artery only. Okay, because it has to flow in a unidirectional. So this valve helps in the protection of the backflow of the blood. Now, usually one general knowledge question or one marker question I am going to help you out with. See, arteries are usually red in color, and veins are usually blue in color. But if you look at the diagram, this is the artery. As I said, what is the color of the artery? Red. But this artery is blue in color. What is the color of the vein? That is blue. But see, look at this color, pulmonary vein. It is red in color. Why? Because the above one are the exception. So there is a one mark question. The only artery which carries deoxygenated blood, so that is pulmonary artery. The only vein which carry oxygenated blood, so this is pulmonary vein. So they both are the exceptions. So this is how the blood circulation takes place. Okay, it's very easy to understand. Okay, not that tough. So I'm going to help you out with this valve. Okay, this right atrioventricular valve is called tricuspid valve. Okay, this left atrioventricular valve is called bicuspid. It has one more name, bicuspid / mitral valve. Okay, mitral valve. Now heartbeat. So heartbeat, usually heartbeat is also called as the cardiac cycle. Okay, each of the heartbeat consists of the two main steps, that is the systole phase and diastole phase. First, I am going to help you with the word systole and diastole, and then we are going to continue with the part. with the consent. Okay, see, the word systole means contraction. Okay, and the word diastole means expansion. The word systole means contraction and the word diastole means expansion. Now, first, try to understand this expansion, or in the book also you can see they have given the other word, that is the relaxation. Expansion means the same only, okay? Expansion or relaxation is one and the same only, so don't get confused. So first, we will understand with the help of shortcut SC, where SC stands for systole contraction, okay, not scheduled cast. And DR, what does DR stands for? Not doctor, it stands for diastole relaxation, okay? Systole contraction, diastole relaxation. First, fit these words in your brain, because as I am going to help you with the concept, explanation of the concept, at that period of a time, you should be able to collect up this word. So systole means contract, okay? What does contract means? This phase. This is the blood vessel which is got contracted. And what do you mean by relaxation? Relax means big in size. See. So first I'm going to help you with this diagram. So this is the systole phase, okay? And this is the diastole phase. The above one is the systole phase, and the second one, this is the first phase, and the second one is the diastole phase. So whenever the blood enters into heart through this superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, so where it enters first? In the right atrium. So when you are going to fill the blood inside this right atrium, so what is going to happen? This is going to get relaxed, okay? This atrium part will get relaxed. Why this atrium part is going to get relaxed? Suppose you take a balloon and try to fill up the water. So what is going to happen with this balloon? The balloon will increase in size with the help of the water. So the balloon size get increased, na? So same like that, whenever the blood enters into the right atrium, it gets swelled up. Not swelled up, exactly it means relaxes, okay? And once, as heart is a muscular organ, so only relaxation is not going to favor. There would be a something very different called contraction. Okay, the muscles work in the two different way, right? If one of the muscles get relaxed, the other get contracted. And now, if the atriums get relaxed, atriums, why I'm using word as a plural? Because this right and left, both of them get relaxed at the same period of a time. So at the same period of a time, as I said, heart is a muscle, so it has to get contracted, okay? So that contraction is done in the ventricular part. Ventricular. With the help of the diagram, we can assume this part. See here, diastole and systole phase. See, what is diastole? Relax. What you mean by systole? Means contract. As I said, DRSC. Just remember in that form. Now, why it is called as a diastole and systole? Let's understand this part. Here, if you look at this right and the left part, okay, of the ventricular side, this is in the relaxed form, okay? In this systole part, if you see the size here, it is very narrow like this, as I said. this is called the contraction phase.
Contraction phase.
Now see, here in this part we can see the relaxation and here we can see the contraction. So they are the two different phase. See, in the above phase, diastole. When does this condition occur? When the ventricular get relaxed. Ventricular get relaxed when the blood is coming into this part, that is here. Okay, so when,
so you can study like this.
Ventricular diastole, so atrium get systole at that period of a time. Okay, and when ventricular gets systole, okay, at that period of a time the atrium become diastole.
Reverse way.
See, here we can see the increase in size of the ventricular, so means the diastole phase, relaxation phase. At that period of a time the atriums are getting contracted. Okay,
see, if the atriums will get contracted, so definitely it is going to transfer the blood to the ventricular part, na?
The blood is going to carry down.
Now
when this ventricular systole occurs like this,
see,
when the size
of this ventricular decreases, means get contracted, okay, at that period of a time it has to pump the blood to each and every part of the body.
So see, the right part sends the blood to the pulmonary artery here, and this left part, which is oxygenated, it transports the blood to the aorta
like this. So this ventricular diastole, atrial systole, ventricular systole and atrial diastole, both works together. Okay, both of these phase work together, so we can call it as the joint diastole also. Okay, joint phase. Now this is the pacemaker. See, so this was all about the diastole and systole, and in the heartbeat, around one heartbeat lasts for 0.85 seconds.
Around 0.85 seconds.
How it lasts up to 0.85 seconds?
Because see, there are two phases, systole, diastole. The systole, when the atrium gets systole, at that period of a time it takes 0.15 seconds.
And when the ventricular gets systole,
ventricular and atrium, at that period of a time inside the ventricular it lasts for 0.30
seconds. Why 0.30 seconds? Because ventricular helps to
because this ventricular systole
because this ventricular has to transport the blood, na? So it stays in for a more period of a time.
If you are going to add this 15 plus 30, so it becomes 0.45 only.
So where this more 40 seconds gone? So as we have four chambers, na?
Heart have four chambers. Upper one and the lower one. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this have four chambers. This four chambers take around 40 seconds, 0.4 seconds. So our heartbeats run for 0.85 seconds.
Okay, so this is all about the seconds part, not minutes. Okay, around in a human, in 1 minute there is around 64 to 70 of the heartbeats. Okay,
we can hear inside a human around.
So this was all about the heart part. Okay, so this was the part 3 of the circulatory system. Thank you, students.